Okay, so this is the this is the figure. Okay, for example, ito yung input or reference natin. Then papasok siya sa input transducer. Then going to controller. Then meron tayong summing junction. This is the disturbance one. Going to the process or plant. Then going to disturbance 2, summing junction. And going to the output or control variable. Okay. So mas maiintindihan natin siya. So sa mga, especially kapag nasa power plant engineering na kayo. And also to sa air conditioning and refrigeration. Okay. So the output signal of all LCS is not fed back to influence the control action. And the control action here of an OLCS depends only on the input signal. The OLCS are not capable of filtering disturbances or noise. So, itong OLCS is, this is the system configuration, the open loop control systems. Okay, so this is the OLCS. Itong pinapakita ko sa inyong picture na yun. Okay, and OLCS are suitable when input signal for satisfactory system performance can be estimated or approximated and does not change. And the advantages of this open loop control systems are the structure is simple compared to a closed control system and is cheaper to build. So, very ano lang to, very simple lang. Ito po, from the input going to output, so just a very simple and according to the research also, it's really cheaper to build. No? So, let's discuss about the closed loop control system or the CLCS. So, ito, kapag meron na tayong feedback, okay, going to, ano, parang may sensor na tayo. So, that's the closed loop control system, unlike sa open loop system. So, from the input, going to the input transducer, going to the error or actuating signal, going to control system, then pupunta tayo sa summing junction. Nandito na yung disturbance 1. Then, going to the process or plant. Then, dito naman yung disturbance 2. Okay? Na nangyayari sa summing junction. Then, going to the output or control variable. But, nagkakaroon ulit tayo ng feedback. Okay? Going to the summing junction. First summing junction. This is the output transducer or sensor. So, the closed loop control systems or the CLS, ito po yung mga definitions niya. The output signal of a CLS is fed back to influence the control's action and improve the overall system performance. Example, the robot arms, velocity control systems, temperature control systems. However, in practical, a combination of both OLCS and CLCS is normally used. For example, washing machine. The process of filling up the tank with water is a CLCS operation, while the process of washing and rinsing is an OLCS operation. So, yun yung ating, kapag nasa washing machine, no? Yung process ng pag-fill up ng tank ng water, yung ginagamit doon, CLCS. Pag-process naman ng washing and rinsing, that's OLCS operation. Okay. Next. Okay, so eto, decide OLCS at CLS or CLCS. So, itong ating lutuan ng ano, oven toaster ng bread, that's OLCS. Open lang siya. Open loop. So, wala siyang feedback. Okay. Ito naman, CLCS. No? Yung mga sa robotic. Ito naman, CLCS. kasi may feedback din siya. Itong ating control, itong air conditioning. Then, ito, OLCS. Okay, yung ating mga Xerox photocopier. Itong washing machine, it's combinations of OLCS and CLCS. So, try draw the block diagram of the system. So, try nyo pong i-block diagram yung ating control system. Yung kanina pinakita ko sa inyo. Mga block diagram. Okay, yan. Okay, yan yung mga block diagram. So, try to figure out to draw the block diagram of this itong these machines na mga pinakita ko sa inyo. Okay, so also get your notebook, no? Then try to draw. Okay, sige. So OLCS versus CLCS. So ano yung advantages and the disadvantages, then the samples of this. So OLCS, simple construction and ease of maintenance. Yan yung advantage niya. Then less expensive than a corresponding closed loop control system, and there is no stability problem. Convenient when output is hard to measure, or measuring the output precisely is economically not feasible. And but there are disadvantages. Ang disadvantage naman niya, the system responds very sensitive to external disturbance and internal variation in system parameters. And recalibration is necessary from time to time in order to maintain the required quality in the output. Example is the toaster, rice cooker, electric fan, photocopy machine. Okay, the CLCS, this is the advantage of this, insensitive to external disturbance and internal variation in system parameters. Possible to use relatively inaccurate and inexpensive components to obtain the accurate control of a given plant and better control of transient and steady state response. So, usually yung mga CLCS natin, ito yung mayroong mga remote control. It increases accuracy, increase ability to reproduce output with varied input, and but there are disadvantages. Meron tayong mga risk, instability, complexity in analysis and implementation, and expensive. So, very inexpensive po yung mga CLCS. Ito yung mga samples, positioning CS or the robot arms, velocity CS or vehicle cruise system, and the temperature CS, the air conditioning.